Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's short video, I will show you how to quickly paint Yujak for the Yujing army for the Infinity. I will use a very small amount of colors and a lot of contrast paints, so I will skip a lot of parts so you don't get annoyed by looking at painting the same color for a couple of minutes. So now sit back, relax, and enjoy this short video. To start, we will base our model with the red bone spray, and when everything is dry, I will start with applying the black Templar contrast. I will use this color straight from the pot, and in one thick coat I will apply it on all the parts that I want to be black on this model. So actually his helm, his gun, the little pipe that goes all around. So this is how I based it actually. The armor parts, we will actually do the same with the Griffhound orange contrast paint. So just one thick coat and apply it on all the armor panels that you want to be yellow later. Just please try to be as much tidy as you can, so we don't need to do a lot of fixing before we are proceeding to next colors. His gas canister on the gun, I use the Flash Tearer's Red, and I also use it for the wall at the top of his backpack. Just one nice thick coat will do the job. Use the Rhinox Kite to base his holster. This is optional, you can paint it black or any other color, but I just wanted to paint it lighter color. Our final base color will be Apothecary White. This is another contrast paint which will I will apply it straight from the pot, and I will try to cover all the white armor panels. So I will try to be as much as neat as possible so it doesn't spill over all the colors, and apply it in one very thick coat. Where everything is dry properly, it's time to start highlighting. So first we will start with the Dark Reaper, and we will use this color on all our black parts. So we will try to do a very thick edge highlight, but still leave most of the areas black. After that part is done, I will start doing the final edge highlight. So I will use Administratum Gray and just draw really nice thin lines on all my sharp edges around the model. Just do this slowly and take your time. This is how our model looks like halfway. So now we will proceed with our next step, and that will be to highlight his gas canisters. So I will use Evil Sun Scarlet, and I will just reinforce the reds, but I will leave the darkest area dark and all the recesses, so just the top areas. And one final little highlight, we will use a Troll Slayer orange and just do the little edge highlights. Time has come to highlight his armor. So we will start with the Aerial Yellow. So just put this color on your palette and add a little water to it just to have a nice consistency so it flows really nicely from your brush, and then just go around all the panels that are orange before and just cover like 80% of them, but still try to leave all the recesses and all the shadows with the previous colors. The last highlight on the armor, I will use Flash Gits Yellow, and this will be just the edge highlight. Little thin lines on all the sharp edges. Just take your patience and go all around and do them. For the white panels, we will do the same process. Just this time I will start with the Ultuan Grey and try to cover 80-90% of the previous white panels, but still leave all the shadows intact and all the dark recesses with the shade. And after that is done, I will take a white scar and do the edge highlight on all the sharpest edges around the model. A few silver rings on his pipes for the gas, and all these pins on the knee pads, so I painted them with a Stonehorse silver. I didn't do any shades because this is such a small detail, so it won't be that obvious. For the last highlight, I forgot to do the holster, so I will use a Scrag Brown, and I will just use a little stippling with my brush to create a worn letter effect. For the final touches, I will do these decoration lines on all his armor. So I will use Evil Sun Scarlet and just try to sketch them a little. Very thin lines in the beginning, and then I will go and do more and more when I come back later to repair and to do them more neatly with a smaller brush. At the end, they should look something like this. And I will just highlight them now. I will use Troll Slayer's orange and just do a little highlights here and there on the thickest lines. Just try not to go to mess your previous white that you did before. And with this detail, our model is completed. I will now transfer him to his base, and he's ready for the game. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please like and subscribe. And if you'd like to see me doing something differently or paint some other model, please make a comment below, and I will try to do my best. And in the next video, I will show you how to make his base. That's all for now. Take care. Bye-bye.